In this step, I'm going to show you how to use mesh lights to create some pretty sexy looking candle flames. I know that we just created some point lights to be like the candlelight, but that was just to introduce you to point lights. I don't actually want them anymore. So we're going to delete those out of the scene. So we'll get rid of that one and that one. I will just point out, if you have any issues with selecting lights, what you can do is just go into your outliner, Windows, Outliner, and all lights, let me just undo, all lights will be listed in here. So if I wanted to get rid of that point light, if I couldn't select it in here for some reason, I can just click it in here and delete it that way. And then if you just want to hide your outline, just click on the tab and it'll just sit on this left-hand side until you're ready for it. Right, before I create my mesh lights then, I decided that I wanted my meshes to be a little bit bigger. So I'm just gonna scale these up a little bit, because they weren't very visible when I practiced this. So let's make them a bit bigger. Now we're just going to pick one. So I'm going to choose the one that's in the corner because I prefer rendering that one. So now that I've got that one selected, we need to go up into Arnold. So we've just been using standard Meyer lights so far, but Arnold has its own set of lights as well. And these generally work pretty well with Arnold because that's what they're built for. So what we're going to do, you have to have the mesh selected for this. We're going to go to mesh light. And what that does is turns the mesh into a light, which kind of makes sense. What we'll do now is make sure that we show original mesh. In fact, what we'll do, let's get IPR rendering going as we're working on this. So I'm actually going to close this view. I want to show you another way to do IPR rendering. So I'm going to change this panel here to a perspective view. And then I'm going to change my renderer to Arnold. You'll see that this little box pops up. And then I can press play. And that's going to start doing some rendering. So at the moment, it's just giving us a fairly basic white light, which is not quite what I'm going for. So we'll just press stop on that for now. And we'll make some changes. And the main change that we need to make is to the color. So instead of just changing the color to be a uniform color, we're going to put a bit of a gradient on it to mimic a little bit more of how a candle flame would look. So we'll click on the little checker button there to make a connection. And we're going to add a ramp, which is what Maya calls sort of its gradient builder. So we'll click on that. And at the moment, we've got a gradient going from black to white. So if we click on black, we're going to make this a fairly deep red color. And then we'll bring that up to about there. So you can see now we're going from red to white. Next color I want, and I'm going to put it, I think, about in the middle for now. We're going to have a fairly orangey color. So let's go somewhere in the orange spectrum. That's pretty nice. Now I need another color in here. So to do that, I just click somewhere in this little rectangle, and that'll bring up a third color. This one's going to be quite yellowy. That's kind of nice. And I want another color like this orange. So I click here. And it's remembered that orange for me. And now what I'm going to do is this area here sort of is how I want my flame to look. So I want it to be orange there, sort of yellow to about there. Let's bring that in a bit closer. Yeah, that looks pretty nice. So that's my gradient that I'm going to use to create my flame. I actually might move these a bit further apart, get a bit more yellow in there. Yeah, that's cool. So that sets up the color. If we now turn on our IPR rendering again, not too much is happening. So let's now start making some changes on this to get the result that we want. So we can see that light is being emitted from it because it's impacting the top of our candle, but it's not yet doing enough. I'm just going to go into my outliner to make sure that I can select my new mesh light, and it will have been put inside the candle group. I've expanded candle group, I've expanded flame, and there is my new mesh light. What I want to do is make sure that I tell it to show the original mesh, and that should get the flame to show up, which does appear to be happening. And then it's up to you to mess with the intensity and exposure until you get a sort of a level of illumination that you like. So I'll start by upping the exposure, I think. That's pretty nice. Let's up the intensity a little as well. I just need it to light the environment a little bit. I don't want to go too far with it. And this is just trial and error until it looks right. What looks right for me might not quite look right for you. So use a bit of your own judgment and see how it comes out. I think I'm pretty happy with that for now. One other setting that you might just want to turn on before you're done is this light visible, which I think looks quite good. It just brings the flame up a little bit more, makes it more visible. So I think that's come out pretty nicely. So all we need to do now is repeat this for the other candle. So I'm just going to run through this dead quick. I'll speed it up so you can see what I'm doing, and then we'll meet up at the end. There we have it then. We've now got two candle flames that are being provided by Arnold Mesh Lights, and I've also introduced you to using the Arnold IPR renderer as one of your panels in your viewport. So I think that was a pretty successful step that we've just gone through together. Well done. In the next step, I want these candles to look more like they're glowing. And in order to do that, we need to simulate like moisture in the air that the light can hit and illuminate. So that involves adding an atmosphere to our scene, which we'll do through the Arnold settings as well. So I will see you in the next step for adding an atmosphere. Game Dev Academy is graciously supported by these absolute legends. If you'd like to offer your support, then check out our Patreon page using the link in the description below.